Hi guys, welcome. I am super excited to share this video with you today because I'm showing you how to make this focaccia bread. And along with this focaccia bread, I'm also going to show you a very quick sandwich that you can make using this bread. And this is the sandwich that I'd eaten in Rome all the way back in 2015 and brings back so many memories. So let's get straight into this recipe. This is a super big bubble focaccia that is going to be so easy to make. You are going to start off first by activating some yeast. I'm going to take some warm water first, and that basically means that when I dip a clean finger in the water, I'm able to comfortably keep my finger in the water without hurting myself. If the water is too hot, if it's boiling hot, the yeast will die. And if it isn't warm enough, then the yeast won't activate. And so this is the best way to test. I've also added some honey to sweeten up the water a little, so the yeast has something to snack on while it's activating. And now here I have some instant yeast, and I'm going to add that in the warm water. By the way, all the details and the ingredients and quantities are in the description box as well. I'm going to give it a quick whisk. I'm going to cover this bowl containing the yeast so that it can activate. In the other bowl now, I am going to weigh my bread flour. I'm using T65 bread flour, which has 13.2% protein content. It has a very high protein content, but you can use all-purpose flour as well. You do want to be mindful though that you'll have to add water a little at a time. And that's because if you're using flour with a low protein content, then it won't need as much water. And a flour with protein content such as the one that I'm using here, which has about 13.2%, will need more water. So that's the reason why you add only a little water first to activate the yeast, and then you'll add a little water at a time until you get the right consistency for your dough, till it's hydrated. You've also noticed that I've added some salt in the flour as well and given it a whisk. So I'm going to add this activated yeast mix into my flour and salt mix like so, and using my spatula, I'm just going to scrape that bowl so I get all of the liquid into the flour mix. And I'm just going to take my spatula and try to hydrate the dough particles. You don't have to knead the dough here, it's just mixing it with a spatula or a wooden spoon. So I've added a little bit more of the water. As you can see, I'm not adding all of it at once. I want to add a little at a time just to test how much water will be needed. I did end up needing all of the water, but like I mentioned, if you are using flour with a lower protein content, like all-purpose flour that has about 10% protein content or so, then you won't need all of the water in the recipe, because a low protein flour will absorb less water, and so you will have to use your judgment here. And this is what the dough really should look like, so you can understand how much water and when to stop. You're also going to add some olive oil at this point after you have mixed the dough together, and then just mix it till the olive oil is well mixed into the dough. And this is the consistency you want. As you can see, it's a very, very hydrated dough, and you won't possibly be able to knead this because it'll be very sticky. And so what you're going to do is you're going to let it rest for 30 minutes now. I'll wrap it with cling wrap and keep it in a warm, dark place. And after 30 minutes, we'll start with our first set of stretch and folds. And now we'll start with our first set of stretches and folds. I have this bowl of water here, which is very important. You do need to dip your fingers in the water here so that it doesn't stick to your fingers, the dough. You don't need a lot of water, you just need to sort of moisten up your hands with the water, so that you can see right here you're able to stretch and fold the dough. And you'll start from one end, then turn the bowl slightly and go stretch and fold this way, and then turn the bowl 90 degrees again and go to the third side like so, and then turn the bowl 90 degrees again and stretch and fold over. And that's your first set of stretch and folds. So every set has four stretches and folds. So you'll stretch and fold, turn the bowl, stretch and fold four times. That is one set of stretches and folds. Now you'll cover it again and let it rest in a warm, dark place for 30 minutes. And then you'll start off with your second set of stretches and folds. So totally you'll be doing it three times. So we've already done once, this is our second time. And every time you go in to stretch and fold the dough, you'll dip your fingers in water. You can see the elasticity of the dough changes, and it increases with every stretch and fold set that you rest your dough for. And that's the reason why this is important. It helps strengthen your dough, which gives you, which kind of creates gluten development. And it gives you that soft big bubble focaccia that you just saw in the video, and it's a perfect bread to make a focaccia sandwich. So this is my second set of stretch and fold done. I'll rest it again for 30 minutes at room temperature in a warm dark place, and this is the final set of stretch and fold that we'll do in this bowl. You can see how jiggly the dough has gone, and it has risen a lot. I just love playing around with this dough because it's so super jiggly. Again, this is the third set of stretch and folds. So again, I'll dip my fingers, clean fingers, in water, and then I will stretch one side of the dough, fold it to the other end, move the bowl 90 degrees, and repeat till I have done four stretches and folds in total. So this is the third set, and each set has four stretches and folds that you need to do. And by now, the dough has become incredibly elastic. Now I'll cover it again, and I will let it rest for another 30 minutes. And this is 30 minutes later. You can see just how nice and risen the dough is, and it's so jiggly and it is strengthened really well. I have a well-greased tray. I've greased it really well on the sides, and I've also put parchment paper on the bottom and added some more oil to it. This is so important. I tested a batch without parchment paper, and it stuck to the base even after being non-stick. So I would always recommend using parchment paper at the bottom. Here you can see I haven't dipped my fingers in water because there's already oil here, and oil does a fabulous job of making sure it doesn't stick. So I have stretched a little bit from all the sides and then inverted the dough ball like this, and I'm going to cover it and let it rest now for 1 hour. I know there is a lot of resting period, but the actual work you're doing is really very less. It's barely 2 to 3 minutes of work every half an hour, so that's totally doable, and the results are very well worth it. You can see 1 hour later now our dough is ready. It is super jiggly. Now I'll add a little bit more oil. I know you must be wondering that there's a lot of oil going in here, but it really isn't all that much, and focaccia does need the oil. So you're going to add in a little bit, and then using the tips of your fingers, you're going to start making these jiggly motions into the dough. And as you do that, you'll see the bubbles start to appear, and it becomes really light and airy. And those dimples that you create really help absorb all of that oil. It drinks up all of that oil, and it's so perfect for your toppings as well. Now you can add a wide range of toppings. I would say if you're using cherry tomatoes or olives, just rub them in some olive oil before you add them to your focaccia, otherwise they'll burn. I have kept it really simple with some flaked sea salt and a generous grating of some Parmesan cheese, because I'll be using it to make a really delicious sandwich using the focaccia. And you'll also preheat your oven before you start doing this at 200 degrees Celsius, and then you'll pop this in the oven at 200 degrees Celsius for about 20 to 25 minutes. The tops of the focaccia should be really nice and golden brown like this. I will run my spatula or a sharp knife along the edges and then take it out, and I will plop it onto my chopping board. It is really hot at this point, so you want to let it cool down slightly. When it's nice and warm, that's when you can cut into it. And now for the moment of truth. Here you go. That looks absolutely incredible. I love the light and airy crumb in this focaccia. It's big bubble and it's really light. And now I'm going to slice into this bread so that I make two halves of this slice of focaccia like this, and look at the crumb structure. That is just so good. And now I'm going to prepare my sandwich. I'm going to try to keep it as close as to the one that I had eaten in Rome. Just popping a picture on the screen here so you can see me actually enjoying this sandwich. It was the best sandwich I had ever eaten. It's so simple, such few ingredients. Just some pesto on one slice of the focaccia, some tomatoes. I'm going to grate some Parmesan cheese, some basil leaves. I'll just tear them and place them on top of the Parmesan and tomatoes. And then I'm going to take some buffalo mozzarella and I'm going to tear it with my fingers and put blobs of this beautiful mozzarella cheese onto the sandwich, on one side of the sandwich. And then I am going to give it a very light drizzle of some more olive oil and just some flaked sea salt on top. And that's it. That's your beautiful sandwich using this focaccia. And I really hope you enjoyed this recipe. And I really hope you make this bread at home. It is so easy and so delicious. If you enjoy this video, please give it a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so you're notified every time I post a new video. If you like this video, you should definitely check out this other video that you see on the screen. I think you'll really like it. I'll see you in another baking video. Until then, goodbye and happy baking!